Welcome back today, Rocket Science. I'm Adam Balkin. Science fiction has shown us what the future might hold for artificial intelligence, like the Terminator series or the new blockbuster Chappie. Although AI isn't omnipresent quite yet, it's becoming a staple in helping some students learn STEM. Our Cheryl Wills checks out how one smart bot is helping some students go to the head of the class.
Students can hardly wait for their third period math class at MS 136. They grab their laptops and a robot takes over from there.
Hello and welcome to the robot version of Race Raymer. Please let me scan your face. Hello, Nicola.
Facial recognition is just one of the many cool things this programmable humanoid robot can do. Nicole stares into the robot's eyes and it remembers her and talks back to her. This Brooklyn school is one of a handful of public schools using this technology to teach STEM subjects.
This robot called Now is so flexible, it's like holding a newborn baby. But this is not a toy, and this sixth grade robotics class is not a game. Here, students are learning critical science and math skills.
Okay, so what did you guys notice with that?
The students are programming the robots to dance to the beat. Sounds easy, it's anything but.
When you program the robot to do a motion, it uses a timeline. So learning how many frames there are in a given time frame, students have to do a lot of rates and ratios for that.
And what happens if students don't program it down to the second?
Loosen his animation.
Ouch! We asked questions with the robot, and we talked to it, and we said either yes or no questions.
Let's say if I want to be like a technician or something, like we could use what we learned here about programming, and we could program games and apps and stuff like that.
The robots, which are made by tech, are pricey, but administrators say it's a small price to pay to help students succeed. For It Ain't Rocket Science, I'm Cheryl Wills.
Now don't get the idea that it's all work and no play for robots, because they have been known to let loose, as our Stephanie Simon shows us.
As children, many of us had imaginary friends. But when dancer Wong Yi was growing up in Taiwan, he wished he could have a robot as a friend. Well, now he's exceeded that dream. He helped create Kuka, a robot who's his muse and his dance partner.
Yes, because I always dreaming when I was a child, I hope I can have a robot.
Wong started studying dance and computer programming at age 13. It wasn't until later in life that he merged the two.
Mostly I teach myself and I do a lot of self-study about the programming. Take the class to learn how to program the robot's language.
He says if he wants to choreograph a one-minute dance, it could take up to 10 hours to program Kuka's moves.
Teaching robot to dance is quite difficult work because it's like making 3D animation in life.
I think in America we think of the robot dance as something that's very jerky and people trying to look like robots. Your dance that you did is a robot that appears to be human.
I used to thought maybe I should act like a robot. Then I found Kuka learn my movement is more interesting.
This duet between Wong and Kuka shows one way in which art, science, technology, engineering, and math can intersect. He says the dance has even inspired future generations of robo-enthusiasts.
Some kids say it's really cool and they really like the robot and they want to have one as well. So I think maybe one day they will have their own robot as well.
For Wong, this dance was his opportunity to make something beautiful out of the sadness and loneliness he sometimes felt as a child. But for others, it may just be the spark that lights a fire for a future career in STEM. For It Ain't Rocket Science, I'm Stephanie Simon.
That robot tango isn't the only place we've seen STEM merging with art this month. Designers at New York Fashion Week have to take a number of engineering and math factors into account when designing their garments. Our Shazia Khan caught up with one custom clothes designer who gave us a behind-the-scenes tour of her design studio.
Designer Dara Lam may have a flair for fashion, but a closer look, and you'll learn she also has a sense of STEM, science, technology, engineering, and math. Inside her New York City studio, Lam shows us the inner workings of her company, which creates custom suits and dresses for women.
It's actually an XY geometry that moves it out and up in certain directions so that curves can be smooth.
Lam says her eye for design, stitched with her background as a math major and a project and systems engineer, is what makes this all possible.
We have an overall engineered system to get the clothing out. Figuring out how to get so many custom elements together and execute them for a client and client after client.
While we now know engineering is part of the equation when creating these pieces, you'll be surprised to learn that physics is also part of the design process.
Physics is really the basic science of understanding how objects and the properties of fabrics may move through space. So we're using physics here to understand when we translate this into an actual fabric, how that fabric will behave.
Lam entered the fashion world by chance when, more than two decades ago, the then 20-something engineer who was presenting to big-name clients found shopping for a quality suit to be more challenging. But Lam quickly learned fashion and STEM are a natural fit.
Oh, it comes in handy every day. I mean, you cannot get through a day without math and science if you are going to be pursuing a passion of providing clothing for somebody.
Sound advice that won't go out of fashion. For It Ain't Rocket Science, I'm Shazia Khan.
Well, that does it for this episode of It Ain't Rocket Science. Remember, to find more hands-on science, technology, engineering, and math opportunities in your neighborhood, head over to www.connectamillionminds.com. And until next time, it's been a blast.